Hello friends, this is Funny Kumar. You are watching Funny EHS Info YouTube channel. Today I am going to discuss about safety officer interview question and answers. Define health, safety and environment. Safety is a condition which gives you freedom from hazard, risk, accident, which may cause injury, damage and loss to material or property damage and even death. Health is a state of complete physical and mental well-being or freedom from disease. And environment is defined as the surroundings in which an organization operates, including air, water, land, natural resources, humans and their relations. Who is competent person? A person with practical knowledge as well as sufficient experience of the particular work, machinery or procedure is known as competent person. Who is safety representative? Safety representatives are employees appointed to act as the eyes and ears for the management by identifying and reporting hazards. Assists in the promotion of safety to ensure a safer work for all and act as a liaison between various employees and also between the employees and different levels of management. What are the duties of safety officer? Implementation of company safety procedures, investigation and analysis of accidents and incidents, carry out inspections and audits in a regular basis, conducting safety inductions and various training programs, identification of hazards and take necessary actions to rectify them, documentation of all safety related activities, ensure that approved PPE used by all employees. What is risk and what are the risk control steps? Risk is a chance, high or low, that somebody will be harmed by the hazard. The risk is controlled by following processes. They are eliminate, replace, reduce, control and personal protective equipment. What is hazard and hazard control steps? Hazard is an inherent property of a substance or an occurrence which has potential to cause loss or damage to property, person or environment. Hazard control steps are elimination, substitution, engineering controls, administrative controls and personal protective equipment. What is risk assessment? It is an examination of what could cause harm to the people as a result of workplace activity in order then appropriate precautions put in place to prevent harm. What is job hazard analysis? It is a hazard identification and control process that breaks a task into several steps, identify the risks associated with each step, and documents the control measures to be used while performing the activity. What is safety tag? A safety tag can be defined as a surface made of cardboard or paperboard on which English or local languages letters written for warning safety instructions to employees. What is LOTO? Lockout tagout is the process for the protection of personnel from unexpected energization or startup of machinery and equipment or release of hazardous energy during installation, demolition or service maintenance activities. What is work permit system and types? Work permit system is a written document for permission to undertake a job by area in charge, or its written document issued by the area in charge to the performer to undertake the job, specific job. Types of work permits are cold work permit, hot work permit is again divided into normal, blanket and delegate work permit, excavation, height work, confined space and radiography work permits. What is blanket permit and delegate work permit? A blanket permit is a permit issued on the basis of location where the multiple jobs are to be carried out at same location. Delegated work permit is used for areas requiring light control, for example in fabrication yards, valid for 30 days. What is confined space? An area which is small and enclosed, where one entry and one exit, or where man can't work comfortable in any location, is called confined space. The examples are vessels, columns, furnaces, tanks, etc. What is a spadding and despadding? The term spadding and despadding is used for mechanical isolation of pipelines containing pressurized liquids and gases. To stop the flow of liquid or gas, a plate is inserted in between flanges to close the line. And removal of this plate is known as despadding. What are the safety controls for confined space entry? Approved work permit, entrant or log sheet, proper access and egress, isolation of toxic and hazardous substances, atmospheric test by AZT, proper ventilation and lighting, communication and emergency devices, signage just for unauthorized entry. What is MSDS? A material safety data sheet is a document prepared by the manufacturer giving product information, emergency information, possible hazards, first aid measures, storage and handling of chemicals, PPE and other information. It includes 16 sections. What is toolbox talk? A toolbox talk is an informal safety meeting that is a part of organization's overall safety program. It includes job-related safety aspects, job-related hazards and risks, control and preventive measures, adequacy of PPE and condition, following safety rules and procedures, safe work procedures and methods. What is first aid? First aid is temporary and immediate care given to the victim of an accident. The purpose of first aid are the minimization of consequences of major injury and the treatment of minor injuries that no need medical attention. First aid for burn person. No lotion of any kind should be applied on the burn area. In case of burn due to corrosive chemicals, the burn part should be flooded with water. The burn area should be covered with a dry sterile dressing. Give some examples about UNSAFE Act. Operating any equipment without proper authority, failure to warning, operating at unsafe speed, failure to use PPE, using hands instead of tools and equipment, unsafe loading and placing or stacking, working on moving equipments, work at height without safety belt are some of the UNSAFE acts. Give some examples about UNSAFE conditions. Unguarded machine or equipment, poor lighting, improper stocking, oil on floor, unsafe ventilation, unsafe defective construction, defective condition of tools and equipment, and bad housekeeping are some of the examples of unsafe conditions. Write a brief about classification of fire. There are mainly five types of fires. Class A, wood, paper, cloths and rubber. Class B, oil, grease, paint, petroleum. Class C, acetylene, ethane and methane. Class D, sodium, magnesium and potassium. And class E, electrical equipment. Write the use of fire extinguishers. Water type fire extinguisher for A class fire, foam type for class B, carbon dioxide for class C, and DCP for class C, D, and E. Define incident, accident, injury, and near miss. An accident is an event which represents deviation from the intended sequence of design steps. An accident is an unexpected or unplanned event which may or may not result in injury or damage or property loss or death. An injury is defined as a harmful condition sustained by a body as a result of an accident. And near miss is an unexpected or unplanned event did not result in injury or damage or property loss or death, but potential to. What is accident investigation? Accident investigation means to carry out immediately the occurrence of accident to find out real facts to avoid the future accident. What is the purpose of accident investigation? The main purpose of accident investigation is to reveal the root cause and to avoid reoccurrence. What are the classification of hazardous material? There are 9 hazard classes, which are explosives, gases, flammable liquids and flammable solids, oxidizing substances, toxic and infectious substances, radioactive material, corrosive and miscellaneous dangerous goods. What is personal protective equipment or PPE? PPE is an equipment used to protect the person from hazards such as dust, dirt, fumes, sparks. It is a barrier between hazard and person. How many types of PPE? There are two types of PPE. One is respiratory protection and another one is non-respiratory protection. The respiratory protection are air supplied, air purified, chemical cartridge respirators, surgical cotton mask, dust filter mask. The non-respiratory PPE are head protection, hard hat, cap and helmet, face and eye protection, safety goggles, hand protection, gloves, foot and leg protection, safety shoes, body protection, apron, hood, coverall, fall protection, safety belts and ear protection, earmuff and earplugs. What is manual handling and hazards and controls of manual handling? The process of lifting, carrying and stacking of material by men is called manual handling. The causes of accidents in manual handling are improper lifting, carrying too heavy loads, improper gripping, failure of usage of PPE, lifting greasy, oily or irregular objects, poor physique. Some of the tips for manual handling are plan, clear the path, move in close to the load, secure your grip, hold your head upright, maintain normal curves of the spine, power the lift with legs and body, don't twist. What are the hazards and controls while using hand tools? The hazards due to wrong way using of tools due to defective condition of tools, due to failure of using right tools for right job, due to wrong way of carrying tools, and due to storage of tools in unsafely. The control measures are: tools must be kept clean and free from corrosion. Keep metal parts lightly oiled. Remove burns from edges of the tools and heads of the chisels. Tools which are not in use must be stored separately. A good worker regularly inspect his tool. Do not use tools without handles. How to prevent accidents of power tools? The operator should wear face shield or safety glasses. Power tool should be placed in the store room after use. Power tool should have protected by guards. Pneumatic hoses or electrical cables of power tools should not pass through passageways. The electrical power tools should be properly attended. Never horseplay with hose or pneumatic tools. Power tools machine should be maintained and operated properly. What precautions are necessary in electrical work? All electrical installations shall be as per standards. Only competent person should handle the electrical equipments. The equipment should be earthen properly. All temporary electrical lines should be drawn at least above man's height. Cable should be completely insulated, not have any joints. Use 3-pin plex instead of loose wires. Good housekeeping on the area. Use rubber gloves and rubber boots. Causes of accidents in construction: erection equipment failure, falling of person from height, electrical shocks, improper lighting, non-stop working by worker, unsafe work methods, collapse of earth during trench excavation, failure of usage of safety equipment, working a height without safety belt. General safety precautions in construction: adequate first aid equipment should be kept ready. Adequate firefighting equipment should be available. Suitable lighting arrangement should be necessary at night. Excavation should be guarded by suitable fencing. The moving parts of grinding machine should be covered with guards. Defective tools should be removed from the service. Workmen at height should wear safety belts. Control measures of radiography: barricade the area, remove all unnecessary persons away from site, check radiation level with dosimeter, use lead shields, put a signboard, use special filter glass, use lead coated aprons. What is TWA and STEL? TWA means time weighted average for 8 hours exposure per day. It is defined as the limit of airborne concentration of a substance under which personnel may be exposed for 8 hours per day without any adverse effects. STEL means short term exposure limit for 15 minutes continuous exposure. It is considered as maximum allowable concentration not to be exceeded at any time during 15 minutes continuous exposure period. It is a maximum concentration to which workers are can be exposed to a period of 15 minutes continuously without suffering from irritation. Safety precautions of scaffold: wooden board not to be painted. Wooden board should not to any cracks. Check for rust in pipes and clamps. Clamp should be fixed and good quality. Board thickness should be 3.4 centimeters and no bendings. The construction must be rigid, properly based. Use of good and sound materials. The wooden valise has not joints. Vertical poles should not be more than 6 feet. Chains, ropes used for the suspension of scaffolding. Never throw any material from heights. Use safety harness while working above 6 feet. Properly ties to be arranged. Safety rules when using ladders. The footwear is not greasy, oily, and muddy and has a good grip on the rugs. Always follow 3-point contact rule. Carry light tools in pockets in your shoulder bag. Never climb higher than the third rung from the top. Step ladder must be fully opened and the divider locked. Metal ladder shall not be used near electrical equipments. Any ladder found defect, it should be marked to do not use. Ladder shall not be placed on a box or drum. Rubber protection on head and heel of the ladder is must. Types of gas cylinders and color codes. Flammable gas, hydrogen, it is in blue color. Oxidizing gas, oxygen, it is in black color. Acidic nature gas, it is chlorine, yellow color. Poisoning gas, ammonia, black and red color. Inert gas, nitrogen, in gray color. Non-flammable acetylene, maroon color. Carbon dioxide, black color. Argon, green color. And helium, blue color. Handling of compressed gas cylinders. They are not to be dragged or dropped. They should be stored in dry and well ventilated places. Chains and slings should not be used to lifting cylinders. Caps of the cylinder should not be removed when they are not in use. Cylinder should not be stored near hot surfaces. Acetylene cylinder should not be stored horizontally. Empty cylinders and full cylinders should be stored separately. Storage of gas cylinders. Cylinder should be stored in a safe, dry and well ventilated store. The standing cylinder should be secured properly, avoid falling. Flammable gas shall be stored at least 50 feet away from other buildings. Oxygen cylinder shall never be stored near flammable gas cylinders. Empty cylinder shall be identified by marking with chalk empty and checked for damage before returning to suppliers. Cylinder should not be kept in supports. Give a brief note about crane. Only authorized and competent person should operate cranes. The correct sling must be used for the load to be lifted. Never be used for loads excess of its safe working load. Check the condition of the ground before parking the crane and use outriggers. Never stand or work under suspended load. Guide ropes shall be used to control swing of lifted materials. Never operate the crane at the time of speed wind. Give brief note about forklift trucks. Check the stability of load before moving it. Never leave your forklift unattended with motor running. Never park forklift truck on passageway. Always drive with a safe speed and slow down at turning points. Avoid carrying loose materials and forks. Warn other employees to stand clear when stacking or removing materials. Fork should be lowered to the floor when the truck is unattended. Stay alert at all times. Give a brief about grinding. Proper wheel should be used as per grinding machine specification. All the grinding machines shall be used with wheel guard. All the cables shall be protected from damage. Provide face shield with safety helmet. Never use fracture wheel. The speed of the grinding should match the speed of the grinding machines. Precautions of excavation. Excavation area should be suitable barricade. Put signboards, lights and flags. Avoid heavy vehicle coming near the sites. PPE like helmet, safety shoes should be used. Keep the excavated soil at least 5 feet distance. Excavated site should be sloped. Hand excavation should be done at presence of underground pipes or cables. All narrow trenches 4 feet or more deep shall be supplied at least one ladder. Describe different types of hazards. Mechanical hazards, inadequately guarding machine parts. Chemical hazards, toxic gases, vapors, fumes, smoke and dust. Electrical hazards, inadequately insulated line wires. Fire hazards, chemical reactions, electrical arcs. Radiation hazards, dazing light, infrared rays, ultraviolet rays. Pollution, water pollution and noise pollution. These are the different types of hazards. Safety in the use of hand trucks. The truck should be inspected. The axle should be greased well. Safety shoes should be worn by the operators. The load should be balanced and the weight of the load should not fall on the axle. The hand cart should be pushed, not to pulled. The truck should not be placed on the pathways. Hazards and controls when working with chemicals. Hazards, harm to skin, lungs and eyes, environmental contamination. Controls and precautions to be observed during this work. Never use a chemical or substance that is not fully identified or no label. Always refer to the chemical data sheet or MSDS before commencing activity. Check protective clothing is usable condition and not damaged before use. Breathing masks and equipment where required must be fully functional and used by trained operatives. Personnel involved in the use of substances must be fully briefed on the nature and hazard of the substance. Eye wash and hygiene stations must be available to workers. Environmental hazards and controls at work locations. Hazards, damage to environment and water sources. Controls and precautions to be observed during the work. Always use hazardous substances with care, ensuring they are suitably stored and empty containers are properly disposed of. Do not waste water by using leaking hoses or running taps unnecessarily. Never use water sources for cleaning tools, etc. and never store hazardous substances nearby. Store potential contaminants in authorized storages and do not take more than it is required to work site. What is Factory Act?
The Factory Act is a social enchantment to achieve social reform and give liberal construction to achieve legislative.
What are main provisions in Factories Act?
Health, safety, welfare, hours of work, employment, person, occupational disease, special provision and penalties and procedures.
What are welfare measures of Factories Act?
Adequate and suitable washing facilities should be provided. Facilities for sitting during rest hours should be provided. If more than 250 workers are employed in a factory, a canteen facility shall be provided. Shelter, restrooms and drinking water shall be provided. Welfare officer shall be employed where more than 50 workers are working.
Sections in Factory Act.
Section 6, Registration of a Factory. Section 11, Cleanliness. Section 13, Ventilation and Temperature. Section 17, Lighting. Section 18, 19, Drinking Water and Sanitary. Section 23, Employment of a Young Person on Dangerous Mechanical. Section 28, Hoist and Lift. Section 29, Lifting Machines and Tackles. Section 35, Protection of Eyes. Section 36, Precaution Against Dangerous Fumes. Section 36A, Use of Portable Electrical Light. Section 38, Protection in Case of Fire. Section 40A, Maintenance of Building. Section 40B, Safety Officer's Duty. Section 45, First Aid Boxes. And Section 111, Obligation of Workers.
What are the hazards and controls in chemical safety?
Hazards: danger due to fire or explosion, danger due to toxicity. Controls: the chemical hazards are controlled by engineering method, administrative method and PPE.
What are causes of accidents of work at height?
Lack of knowledge and skills, feeling of dizziness, non-usage of PPE like safety belt, unsafe platform, improper erecting, unlearning work at height safety rules.
Control measures of work at height.
Use safety belt with proper anchoring above head. Special training must be given before starting the job. All scaffolds must be erected by skilled persons. No work after sunset. Every platform should be free from unnecessary obstructions. Grease, mud, paint removed from the working platform.
What is earthing? Earthing means connecting the natural point of supply system to the general mass of earth by line. What is static electricity? It is an imbalance of electrical charges within or on the surface of the material. The charge remains until it is able to move away by means of an electrical current or electrical discharge. A static electrical charge can be created whenever two surfaces are contact and separate.
What is ELCB? ELCB means Earth Leakage Circuit Breaker. It is protection of living being under electrocharging by fast isolation from the life conductor to avoid permanent disability or death. What is GFCI? GFCI means ground fault circuit interrupter. It is a device which measures the amount of current flowing to and from an electrical source. What is tram cord? A tram cord or a transport emergency cord, as it is also known as, a document that is used when transporting dangerous goods. The tram cord contains important safety information about the vehicle loads. It is a legal requirement in case of emergency in vehicles carrying hazardous substances. How many types of signboards? There are 6 main types of signboards. They are mandatory, information, danger, fire or explosion, caution and warning signboards. What is color coding system? This system followed to inspect the tools and equipments periodically, like lifting gears, power tools, etc. These things inspected by competent person and are marked with the color of particular month. The items which are found defective or unserviceable will not be color coded and has to be removed from the service. How to respond in case of emergency? You have to respond in case of emergency by following these 4 steps. First one, emergency notice. Shout and inform to everybody. Contact ERT means emergency response team. Second step, stop work. Stop work and shut down all equipment. Third step, assembly point. Check wind direction to safe evacuation quickly. Fourth step, treatment. First aid will take care injured person until the medical help. Thanks for watching Funny EHS Info. For any questions, please text me in comments. And don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thank you and have a safe day.